provide for the common defense. And President Donald Trump always puts our armed forces and your families first. I've seen it firsthand. On our very first day in office, I witnessed President Trump protect our military from a government-wide hiring freeze, and in May of last year, he signed the largest increase in military spending in nearly a decade. And with the leadership and support of this Commander-in-Chief, our armed forces have taken the fight to the terrorists of ISIS on our terms, on their soil. Their caliphate has crumbled, and soon we will erase ISIS from the face of the earth. Last August, our president laid out our South Asia strategy to give our warfighters in Afghanistan, in his words, the tools they need and the trust they've earned to fight and win. This president has also secured commitments around the world from our allies, commitments from our NATO allies in particular, to pay more for our common defense than ever before. And President Trump has articulated a vision to ensure continued American dominance in land, sea, air, and space. Our president led negotiations with both parties of Congress, and President Trump signed into law the largest increase in our national defense in a generation. Under President Donald Trump, the days of arbitrary budget cuts to our national defense are over. And finally, in June of this year, while our president engaged in historic negotiations with North Korea, he had our missing fallen on his heart. And as the by signing this legislation today, President Trump is keeping his promise to the American people to rebuild our military. Men and women of the armed forces of the United States of America, the 45th President of the United States, President Donald Trump.
Thank you. The National Defense Authorization. Authorization Act is the most significant investment in our military and our warfighters in modern history, and I am very proud to be a big, big part of it. It was not very hard. You know, I went to Congress, I said, let's do it, we got to do it. We're going to strengthen our military like never, ever before, and that's what we did. I want to say very strongly, there is no better place than right here at Fort Drum to celebrate its passage. No better place. After years of devastating cuts, we're now rebuilding our military like we never have before, ever. Because we know that to survive and having that survival of our freedom, it depends upon the might of our military. Nobody's even close, and never will be. We're grateful to be joined today by many of our nation's top military leaders. I'd like to
Thank you, Mr. President. It is truly an honor to welcome you to Fort Drum, home of the historic 10th Mountain Division, the most deployed unit in the U.S. Army since 9/11. Thank you for being here to sign the historic National Defense Authorization Act, which includes the largest pay increase, support for our military families, and investing in our military readiness. Climb to glory, 10th Mountain Division. Thank you.
Incredible representative. I also want to thank Representative Don Baker. America is a peaceful nation, but if conflict is forced upon us, we will fight and we will win. Because you're very patriotic, you say, just save the money, you're going to pay down debt. Does anybody not want it? Please raise your hand. What's going on here? Are these real patriots? I don't know, General. I don't know. It's the biggest increase in a decade. A strong military also requires a strong economy, and our economy is setting records like never before. We have the greatest economy we've ever had. I think that's going to help us a lot in a lot of ways. It also helps us a lot in funding and doing all of the things we're doing for our great military. We've created almost 4 million new jobs since the election, a number that the media in the back would never have said would be possible. If during the campaign. And we believe our warfighters deserve the tools, the equipment, and resources they have earned with their blood, sweat, and tears. In a few moments, in honor of that sacred obligation, I will put my signature on the National Defense Authorization Act. This authorization will give America's warfighters the firepower they need to win any conflict quickly and decisively. Thanks to the leadership of Representative Stefanik, we're also making an unprecedented commitment to developing our artificial intelligence capabilities. In order to maintain America's military supremacy, we must always be on the cutting edge. That is why we are also proudly reasserting America's legacy of leadership in space. Our foreign competitors and adversaries have already begun weaponizing space, developing new technologies to disrupt vital communications, blind satellites, and you look at what they're doing, they've given me rundowns. I've seen things that you don't even want to see, what they're doing and how advanced they are. We'll be catching them very shortly. They want to jam transmissions, which threaten our battlefield operations and so many other things. We will be so far ahead of them in a very short period of time, your head will spin. China even launched a new military division to oversee its warfighting programs in space, just like domain. It is not enough to merely have an American presence in space. We must have American dominance in space, and that is why just a few days ago, the Vice President outlined my administration's plan to create a sixth branch of the United States military called the United States Space Force. We will ensure that the next great chapter in history is written by the heroes of the United States military. America will always rise to every challenge and overcome every danger because we are backed by the strength and power of the American soldier. Speaking to his troops, General George Patton, a great one, once said, "We have the finest equipment and the best spirit and the best men in the world." Now, if it were today, he would be saying the best men and women in the world. Things do change. But that was quite a statement many years ago. Continuing his remarks, Patton then declared, "I don't want to get any messages saying I am holding my position. We are not holding a damn thing. We are advancing constantly." That was Patton. Nearly 75 years later, Patton's words still ring true. America has the best equipment anywhere in the world. We have the best spirit, the best soldiers ever to set foot on any battlefield, anywhere, at any time. We are the most powerful. We are the best funded. We are the biggest. We are the strongest. We are the smartest. And we are still not holding a damn thing because America is on the move once again. And we are not backing down. Our country is respected again. I don't know if you see it, but American soldiers from the 10th Mountain Division, 2nd Brigade Combat Team to join me on stage to sign the National Defense Authorization Act. It's been an honor to be with you today. Thank you all very much. Thank you.
This is it, but I'll just sign it. I won't be here alone.